2018, I think, was a super year. I think there was a lot of exciting things happening in the microbiome space, particularly on the science. I mean, there's been a lot of really high-end publications, which I think show that we're gaining more insight into, you know, compositions in healthy and diseased individuals, but also tapping into mechanisms of how bacteria might be influencing human health in many, many ways. So the other aspect, which I think was really important and I think shows the confidence in the industry at this time, was the number of investments that we've seen. So I'm thinking particularly of maybe pharma's commitment, which I think is a great indicator for the industry and as a whole. So thinking maybe one of the lovely deals was when we seen the acquisition of Rebiotix by Ferring. It's the first acquisition in the fields. It's great news. And then also closer to home, we saw one of our portfolios, Microbiotica, secured Genentech funding. So I think that was, for me, some of the highlights of 2018. I have the feeling that 2019 is quite an important year. A lot of the companies, I call them the front runners in the field, they're coming into very critical clinical trial readouts, so be it sort of phase two, some even in phase three. And I guess what we're waiting for is we want to hear the success. And I think for me, hearing success from those trials is going to be very important for the field, very important to keep the confidence and keeping the momentum that we have now. Clearly, probably I think listening to and having real insight into startups and what they're doing. I'd say the biggest obstacle is, you know, navigating basically new products, so be it consumer or medicines, drugs, through a regulatory course that's not very well defined. And, you know, whilst we know the FDA are doing their best to provide guidance, I think that's probably the one particular bottleneck that I think, and a hurdle that I know companies are dealing with. That said, my sense is that there are so many new companies that there's pressure on the regulatory bodies now to try to navigate and give good guidance on how trials, for example, clinical trials should be conducted. So on that point, I'm very positive about really the regulatory front in the future and where it's going. The Health for Life Fund allowed Seventure to invest in a number of early stage startups in the microbiome space. And I think we have approximately 15, 16 investments now. And that period that started from about 2011. So if you think about it, we've been investing for a number of years now, and during those years we've learned a lot about the microbiome, not just the science, but how to navigate end-to-end, taking science, preclinical work right through into clinic. And in that, I think that knowledge, that ecosystem, we've got a very good network, and I think Isabel and the team are able to really help companies grow and where they hit challenges. So for example, we mentioned earlier issues like regulatory hurdles. You know, there's a really sort of collaborative approach to that. And I think the feedback we have from the company is they're obviously getting enough support. That said, I think, you know, obviously the industry is a new industry. And I think as time goes, the support around regulatory and other things will get even better.